Each year, science learning centers are created and implemented by education students from Vancouver Island University. They are hands-on activity centers focusing on themes such as forces in motion, the environment, space, and kitchen chemistry. These centers are part of a Vancouver Island University tradition of making a contribution back to local elementary schools. Over 14,000 elementary students have attended these centers so far. The Faculty of Education Science Learning Centers provide an engaging and exciting day for students and teachers alike. Our education students expend considerable time, thought, energy, and money to create these centers.
I'm Jenny, and I'm Amanda. And for our science center, we did dinosaurs. Centers we made up for kindergarten to grade three, and Amanda's gonna kind of run you through those.
Ships that have the different dinosaurs on them that we're gonna introduce to the kids, to threes, so that they can get familiar with what the dinosaurs look like and what their names are. And then we have a coloring sheet for the K-3s to do.
One of us will be reading this intro sheet, and it'll give off a couple of characteristics about each dinosaur. And then we have this fossil box, and on these sticks here, it tells which dinosaur it is, and we're going to bury them in the fossil box, and then the students will try and dig and find the names, and when they find a name, they'll have to tell us, pronounce the name, and tell us one characteristic about it. So that will assess kind of what they learned while we were speaking. This can also be for, it's made for 4 to 7, but a grade 3 class could do it as well. Again, it's with the fossil boxes. And what it is we have this little quiz. And to introduce the activity, they're going to be watching a little clip on our laptop of, it's called fossilification, and it just shows the levels of how fossils are made. It's maybe 2 minutes long.
Okay.
So they'll watch that, and while they're watching, Amanda and I will be reading what's on the screen so that they don't have to try and read and try and watch at the same time, because they might not pick everything. And once all 5 questions are answered, they'll hand it in to Amanda or myself, and we'll just kind of go over it just to make sure that they're on the right track, and that's our way of assessing them.
For the grade 7 quiz is similar to the one that we have just shown you, except it's a little bit more modified for the older kids to make it a little bit more difficult. They're doing a timed quiz, and when they get the answer, they get to press the easy one.
So what they're going to do is, because we will probably have 4 students in a group, we'll split them into 2 teams. Again, they'll get this quiz. And instead of us reading it, we're hoping the grade 7s are able to just read this paragraph. This is their quiz down here. So what Amanda and I will be doing is we will say the question, and then the grade 7s will get 15 to 20 seconds to dig as hard as they can to find the correct answer. Now, all the answers will be buried in the box, so the trick is they have to find the right answer to the question that we're asking them. And the first person to get the right answer before time's up will hit that button. And we'll keep score, and the first team to win.
Stop! Amanda was the best
thing. Stop. Okay, who is them? What is the correct answer?
Oh, now cover them all up.
Okay, so cover them up.
Elementary students are thrilled to participate in a variety of science activities that play out before their eyes. Inspiring thought. Inspiring action. Inspiring teaching. The VIU, Faculty of Education, Science Learning Centers.